Good morning, children. So a fresh week has started. Today is Monday and we begin a new lesson today. We'll do a new lesson, very interesting one, a good story, Princess September, from the book It So Happened for class 8. So let's begin. Now this is an interesting story that talks about the love and bond of humans and birds. Yes, human beings are very much fond of birds and animals. Freedom is the basic right of every individual. Yes, very true. Our constitution also highlights this. No one should take it away for his own greed. Doing good always pays back in the manifold. In many ways, you get it back. The princess was a good human being. So in this lesson, princess was a very good human being. Her essential goodness was reflected in her behavior with the bird. She was very good to the birds. She loved birds. She believed in live and let live. In contrast to her, her sisters did evil and received the evil fate in return. Now she was very good, whereas her sisters were very bad, evil, and because they indulged in all evil deeds, they got it back as the evil fate in return. Okay, so now let's begin the summary of Princess September. The story is set in Thailand. All of you are very familiar with this place, Thailand. There live a king and his queen with many daughters. So there lived a king in Thailand. Okay. And his queen with many daughters. To make it easy to remember the names of his daughters, he kept their names on months. Youngest daughter was named what? September. After the months, January, February, you know that. So the king gave away gifts on his birthday. Once he gave green parrots in a golden cage to all his daughters. The princes were fond of parrots and taught them what? To talk. So princess was so fond of her parrots, she taught them how to talk. God save the king and pretty Polly. So what did they say? God save the king and pretty Polly. One day, Princess September found a parrot lying dead in the cage. Oh my God, she must have felt so sad. It was heart-rending to her. She was so sad, so disappointed with this. She kept on crying at the loss. Loss of what? Parrot. Her maids of honor tried to comfort her but failed in their effort. That means she was crying so much, maids could not stop her from that. So they went to the queen, who did not pay heed to her distress. The maid of honor was to go to a party, left the princess crying in bed with taking supper. Then they entered a little bird and hopped into her room. It started singing a beautiful song about the lake in the king's garden, willow trees, goldfish, etc., that made September forget all her sadness and hunger. So when she saw all these creatures, she forgot her sadness and hunger. The little bird offered herself in place of a pet parrot. Princess September was delighted. She was so happy to own such a melodious singing bird. So the bird could sing so melodiously, so sweetly the bird was singing. The next morning, he wished her good morning when the maid of honor brought her breakfast. It was fed to him by the princess. So princess herself fed that bird. His singing impressed the audiences and the princess feels elated. Elated means extremely happy. She then took him to tour to her sisters and parents. She got that bird introduced to her sisters and parents. Everyone was delighted by his performance. Queen did not like the parrot saying repeated lines. That was not liked by the queen. Whereas the king admired the parrot saying, God save the king, yet condemned Pretty Polly. The people liked that God save the king, but nobody liked Pretty Polly. That discouraged the princesses and their parrot. Then what happened? September enjoyed the song of the bird. She was so fond of the bird, the song. They went on for a few days, unless the other sister poisoned the mind. They said that she had to bear the death of a pet and they would arrange a parrot for her. But September replied that she did not need parrot anymore as she had a better bird. They asked the whereabouts of the bird, to which she replied that the bird flew off to meet his father-in-law. Actually, she was lying, do you know, children? The princess tried to scare her that he might not come back because they did not want that bird to come back because he was not caged. Their persistent nagging made her uncomfortable all the time after the same matter. Insecure Princess September felt that something might happen to him. But Princess September understood what? That now something terrible is going to happen. She could feel that. She could predict that. She was worried that hawks, hawks are very dangerous bird, hawks and eagles. So she was worried that hawks or someone might have trapped him. She understood. So all she wanted was his safety. She feared that somebody might have trapped him. Then appeared the bird and started chirping in her ears, started singing. She grew angry. The bird told her that he would not have replied as his father-in-law was giving a party. Okay, he wanted him to attend the party, but he knew that she would be worried, so he returned. September was not willing to take any chance further. She decided to cage him. So what did Princess September do? She put him in a cage. The bird was shocked at the sudden reaction of her because earlier she never did such a thing. She never caged the bird. The reason she gave was the queen's cat might harm her. The bird agreed to it, but for once only. He wanted to sing after supper but could not continue because he did not feel like singing. Naturally, you know, birds are never happy if you put them in a cage. How can they feel like singing? So here also the same is the condition. The bird is so unhappy. The next morning he wanted to be free. His desperation grew. That is, it increased and increased and increased. What happened? He beat against the door, started beating against the door and shout, but all his efforts were in vain, means useless. Rather, 8 princesses were delighted to see him in pain. The 8 princesses, they were so happy to see this bird in pain, the parrot in pain, because they are already very wicked, na? On the request to set him free, September replied that she knew what's better of him. She wanted him to sing for her and offered him a piece of sugar. He could not sing inside the cage. No, birds feel so unhappy inside the limited space there. He wanted to see the trees, to fly in the open, to enjoy the beauty of nature, the lake, the willow trees, all by himself. He was not willing to see through the cage. He gave up eating. He stopped eating, singing. Then anxious princess, she was so worried, turned to her sisters for their opinion, for their advice, for their suggestion. They called him obstinate. You know what is obstinate, children? Very stubborn, not willing to obey, and wanted her to conform to her stand. September agreed to their suggestion and felt the same way. She assumed that he might be accustomed to bars of the cage. The next morning she wished the bird but got no answer. Because why? The bird is so unhappy. She was shocked to see that the bird was living unmoved in the cage, lying unmoved. She took him out of the cage and started crying. It means what? What does it mean? That the bird is dead. The bird must have been so sad. It must have died because of what? Unhappiness, sadness, worry, tension. What for that unhappiness must have been there in that bird? It could not fly in the open. Birds, always remember, children never like to be put in a cage. Their freedom, you cannot restrict their freedom. God has created birds to fly in the open sky. How vast is the sky, children? Imagine. Birds are happy only in the sky when they're left in the open. See, we humans have got no right to put them in a cage, to curtail their freedom, to curtail their happiness. See, look here at the condition of the bird here, the parrot. According to you, why did it die? It was very unhappy inside a cage. It did not want to be locked inside a cage. It must have died because of sadness, because of unhappiness. So Princess September started crying when her tears fell on him. He looked up. Yes. So when Princess September started crying, what did the bird do? It looked up. It means it is not yet dead. He pleaded that he could not sing inside the cage. I told you, children, birds are never happy inside a cage. And if he could not sing, he would die. So she freed him then and there, removed that bird from the cage. He promised her that he would return to her. She sobbed and was feeling lonely. She started crying. She was feeling lonely without the bird. Her sisters mocked at her. Mock means made fun of her. But he returned to her and sang beautiful songs for her. Why? Because the bird is now happy to be left free. She kept her windows open to let him go or come whenever he felt like. Now the bird is enjoying its freedom. All birds want to be left free. She grew beautiful and got married to the king of Cambodia and was carried on a white elephant. Her sisters were married to the counselor only, as they were not as beautiful. So that is what happened. Yes. So children, see, the most important thing that you learn from this story is what, do you know? Never keep birds inside the cage. Leave them free. Let them enjoy the beauty. You also enjoy the beauty of the birds flying, singing, chirping. See, you feel so good when early in the morning you hear the chirping of birds. That is what wakes you up, isn't it? We all get up when we hear, we come to know. Now it is what? Dawn. Dawn means early morning when you hear the chirping of the birds. It is so beautiful. You feel so happy to listen to the chirping. It is like an alarm for you. Alarm what? Morning, you don't have to set alarm in your watches, in your clocks. The birds are the alarm for you. What? They tell you, wake up, wake up, wake up. And always remember that you must give the birds their due freedom. How? By leaving them free. Never ever curtail their freedom. Never ever keep them inside a cage. Why? Because they become unhappy. Will you like it if you are put in a very small room? No. So the same is the condition with the birds. So never keep birds in a cage. Look at them. Enjoy their beauty. Enjoy their songs. Children, read this lesson thoroughly. Read this story. Very interesting. Underline all the difficult words. This is your assignment. And write down the meanings of all the difficult words. Don't forget to complete your assignment. Thank you. Goodbye.